Hello guys, in this video I'll show you how to send email using NodeMailer, Node.js and Gmail. In order to send mail from Gmail using NodeMailer, we need to do some configuration. So let's do it. So guys, you can see this is my Gmail account, and click on the security and then enable the less secure apps. You can see I have already enabled. Create a new folder on the desktop and name it as a NodeMail. And now open this folder using any text editor. I'm going to open with the Visual Studio Code Editor. So guys, create a new file in this folder, name it as a app.js. And now we need to initialize this project as a node project, and we can do this by typing a command npm init and pass a flag to it -y so that it can skip all the questionnaires. And then guys, install a package named as NodeMailer in this project. So we can install a package using a command npm I stands for install, and the package name is NodeMailer. So until this package is installing, let's go and create a new variable in this app.js file, and then variable name is NodeMailer. And we need to require a files from package that we have installed, and that is NodeMailer. And then guys, create a function called send custom email, and this not sends, it's sent. And this function takes a three parameters, and the parameters are email to, and the subject and the text. And then guys, we need to create a transporter. A transporter is a function which takes our custom email message and send to the recipient. So to create a transporter, we need a variable that let's name it as a transporter, and we can create a transporter using NodeMailer that we have defined earlier, and NodeMailer, and we have a method called create transporter, and this create transporter takes an object, and that object has a fields, and the fields are host, port, auth. Auth itself is an object which takes two parameter, and the parameters are user and password. And don't worry guys, I will fill all these values. So I'm just telling you what are the fields and parameters are required to create a transporter. And then we need a secure, and it's a boolean type. So for now, just put a true here. And then guys, we need to create our custom email message so that we can send to the recipient. And now let's create our custom message. So I'll name it as a message, and it is an object type. This message takes four fields, and the fields are from takes a sender email ID, and then we need a two takes a recipient mail ID, and then we need a subject, and then we need a text, and text means the email body. And then guys, now it's time to fill all these values. So I'm just filling the host. Host means which provide you the email service, like Outlook, Gmail, Zoho and other email services. So we have used Gmail, so I'm going to put it here, smtp.gmail.com. And the Gmail uses by default port is 465, and the auth user takes sender email ID. So I'm going to send all the emails from my mail ID is quickcodedroid@gmail.com, and the pass field requires the password of sender mail ID. And I highly recommend to you guys, don't put your password here. Please use the node environment variables, and it is an example, that's why I'm putting my password here. Secure fields need to be true because this is a secure connection. Transporter will create a secure connection with your SMTP mail server. With the Gmail SMTP mail server, and then we need to fill our custom message fields from you can put like no reply @gmail.com, and then we need to put the recipient mail ID. So I will send my mail to the smartydeveloper@gmail.com, and then we need the subject. Guys, I have statically typed the recipient mail ID, so but we have passed the parameter email to in our function, so that I'll just removed it and I'll put it here email to, and I'll do same with the subject and also with the text. And guys, we have created our transporter and our custom message. Now we need to send this custom mail to the our recipient. So how can we do that? We need to take our transporter and just call the function send mail and just pass our custom mail message to it. And then guys, the send mail message is a promise and we need to change it. Either we can use async await method or we can use then and catch. So I'll use dot then. When this function is executed completely or successfully, it will execute dot then method, and the dot then method takes an function, and I'm going to use a ES6 function which is arrow function, and the arrow function takes an a parameter of response. When this message sends successfully, then block will be executed, and I'm going to put a print method console log so that we can see our message sent successfully. So email sent successfully, and then guys, if in case some error occurred, then we need to also catch the error, so we can use catch method, and the same thing we have done with the then we need to do here, and we can simply put them message console.log something went wrong. And then guys, we have created our function completely, and now we need to call this send custom email to send mail to the recipient. Now we need, how we can call this method? We can simply call this method by using a function name and close the braces, and it takes three parameters. So you can see my ID is suggesting it takes email to, subject and text. So now the email to is a recipient mail ID, and I'm going to put here and the subject is verify your email, and then in the body click link below to verify your email ID. And now we need to execute this file. So to execute this file, we can type a command node and the file name. My file name is app.js, so I'll write app.js and then hit the enter. And now you can see console log has printed email sent successfully, and we have done. So in my mailbox you can see I receive an email with the quick code droid, and the subject is verify your email, and the my text is click link below to verify your email ID. So thanks for watching this video guys, I hope to see you in the next video.